phospholipid and cyclodextrin based drug delivery system, novel and controlled drug delivery, nanoparticles, etc. He has 2 patents in his credit. He is the university's VIM coordinator, single point of contact, NEPTEL local chapter. It's amazing that Sir has developed more than 100 hours of e-contents and e-modules. He is the course coordinator of academic writing since 2018, which has ranked number 1 in MOOC of country and ranked in top 30 MOOCs in worldwide. He is also the course coordinator of Industrial Pharmacy 1. And like this, the list is endless. With this brief introduction, I invite Dr. Ajay Samarji to start the session on e-learning MOOCs in education. Sir, please, sir.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, friends. I think I'm audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. First of all, thanks for inviting in the prestigious JSS College of Nursing. So it is my privilege to be on this platform and interacting with you people. I have been associated with MOOCs and online learning for last 3 years, maybe. Started in 2017 learning these things, and now trying to be comfortable with the advancement of online learning and all the things put together along with the MOOCs. And all of a sudden, after the March, after the COVID-19 scenario, I don't think so, I should say it, fortunate event or unfortunate event, that the importance of online learning and teaching or the MOOCs have been re-emphasized by the time itself. You know, the things which government couldn't do for last 3 years, it means government is doing, but it could not came into the grassroots level. Only this lockdown has, you know, metamorphosized the necessity of online learning and the importance of MOOCs. The people are now comfortable and well acquainted nowadays with the MOOC, the concept of MOOC and online learning, because it has become the necessity now. Okay. So friends, without any further delay, I will take you directly to my presentation, and then we will have a quick Q&A session in which you are welcome with all your queries. I think apart from theoretical concept, it is utmost important to become acquainted with the practical aspects of all these things. Because being a teacher, being a learner, we must learn the things practically. So let us take you to my presentation directly. I think you can see my screen now. Okay. Getting my screen?
Yes, okay. Sir, we are able to see.
But now let's move. So e-learning and MOOCs in education. is today's topic. And myself, Dr. Ajay Similty, welcome you all. Moving ahead, here are the 10 commandments of online teaching and learning. I'll be focusing on, and then we, meanwhile, we'll be focusing on the SWAM and concepts of MOOCs and successful features of developing the MOOCs. Okay. So let me take you these one by one rather than enumerating all these things for you, moving directly to the first commandment, that is explore and refer SWAM. Now, you know, SWAM is a government platform, MHRD's initiative, which focused on the access, equity, and quality of the education. It is the three; they are the three cardinal principles of our education policy. They have been, and they are going to be the cardinal principles always. We want to give the education to everyone with equal access, equity, and with the good quality. So you might be knowing about the SWAM portal, which provides a lot of e-learning materials. So this is, you can take the snap of this thing. However, I will take you that how digital learning initiatives are being floated by the Government of India, MHRD, UGC. These are the a few digital learning initiatives which are there on the SWAM website itself. So I'll directly take you to the SWAM website first, and then we'll be focusing them one by one. I will take you to this website of SWAM. Just a minute. Yeah. So as far as, just a minute, huh? Just a minute. Yes. This is the website of SWAM. The website, can you see my screen? Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So this is the website of SWAM. You know very well, I think most of, I think earlier speakers might have told you, but just I want to emphasize that ICT initiatives of MHRD and these Let COVID-19 Not Stop Your Learning, Continue with SWAM. These are, if you click in these two boxes on the right, you will get the, all the links of all the initiatives of MHRD and Government of India, which are provided for free to everyone from the across the world. Anyone can access, rather. It is not just for country, rather anyone can learn. SWAM, all the courses, SWAM Prabha, which is a group of 32 DTH channels. If you click here, you will be directed to the SWAM Prabha. The SWAM Prabha is a DTH channel. I have been also been recording the things, and my programs of around 24 hours are going to be telecasted soon in the SWAM Prabha. So we are right now, we are also recording for the SWAM Prabha and developing the contents, videos right from our home itself with a special assignment. So what you can do, you can see the channel and allocations here, okay? But I mean to say, Jio app, in the Jio app, SWAM Prabha channel is easily visible. If you are having a SIM of Jio, connection of Jio, you can have all these things. So if you see the channel 15, channel 15 is dedicated for our subject like nursing, pharmaceutical sciences, and all allied sciences, biomedical, biotechnology, then you can have this channel. But you have to do, you have to go to these channels, and the live you can see, and the which are already telecasted are given in the form of YouTube channel. So Samprabha has also got a YouTube channel. So whatever have been telecasted already is let me take you channel 30 channel. Yeah, like I will take you directly to the channel 15. So you will get the link of channels here. The server is a little bit slow. The technology has its own limitations. In general, I get 100 Mbps at least in my department. Today, I think I'm not getting that much speed. Anyway, So you can see the EPG Parsala, Shodh Ganga, Esho Sindhu, E-Yantra. You go to these, each and every link. Virtual Labs is a wonderful one. You can see the web-enabled experience designed for remote operations. And Vidwan is a portal, which is a data bank of experts, academic experts. And all these platforms are very wonderful platform and freely available. Sorry, it's not connected. Yeah, I got it now. Channel 15. Say, for example, it is run by run in IIT Madras. You can see that today it is the upcoming one. Okay, so when on 17th of July, Friday, this topic is going to be delivered like this. You can have this list. Okay, the biotechnology, engineering, okay, and other allied sciences. Especially if you want to go for the biomedical sciences, nursing, and all that, you can get it from the channel 15 only. Okay. So current one is a timing you can see here. You can see it through the net or to the DTH, free DTH. If you see the DTH, Doordarshan, that free DTH, you will get these timings and schedule is there. If archive one, archives are archived in YouTube. So you can have this YouTube link directly of this particular topic. Say, for example, I'm going to...
Hello, sir. Can you hear me,
sir? No, I'll tell him.
Sir, we are not.
For example, how can I think going for my regular course to a MOOC course? Okay, multidisciplinary one. So, in general, these things are already available. You can see, I request all the participants to go to these channel 15 archive. You will see this YouTube. Okay, so you can go just go to the YouTube, which whatever have been telecasted, it is Professor Sohana Murthy from IIT Mumbai. She is, one of the pioneer one in the delivering this MOOCs and all the things. So you can get this thing, you can download them, you can see them. Okay. So yeah, so this way you can learn the things wonderfully. Okay. And you can, if you are a teacher, you can also contribute. You can send the proposal to Swayamprabha for getting these, proposals done, and you can also telecasting. But right now it is closed due to COVID-19. Only the people who are already in the domain are being invited, and they are doing the work. Like my team is working, and in my team we have already prepared 24 hours of video, and 24 hours of rest of the videos are under production. So all courses, if you go, say for example, I take my course, I type academic writing here, and this search bar, however, we can select it from the things. You can see the academic writing course, which is my course. I think more than 3,000 have already enrolled, and I'm expecting it to be cross it for 10,000 this time. So you can join here. I think you just go to the join. If you click to the join, you can join it by the Google, okay, or your Gmail ID, and just directly you can go to that particular course. Okay, so right now please explore it. I'm not going into detail in the interest of time. You can see the objective of the course, what is being covered here in the course. You can see there, like what we have covered upon completing this course. This is the course on week one, academic research writing, week two, English, week three, plagiarism, week four, journal metrics, author metrics. So different videos, contents are available, audio contents are, audio video contents are available, e-contents are available, discussion forum is available, and Q&A, quiz, assignment. These are the four quadrants. Many of you, many of the speakers might have told you. So just, you can see the instructor, instructor's bio here. Okay, and just have an idea. And from single ID, you can enroll in n number of courses. But you can give the, you can select the courses for your exam or certification by seeing the exam date. You cannot have in single exam date, in single slot, you cannot give the two exams. So always remember this thing, choose well in advance to which course you want to give the exam and get the certificate. Okay, only for the certification and exam, you have to give a little amount, that is around 1000 rupees for examination. And that too, it is to be paid around at the end of the course. It means for learning, every course is free. Okay, I'm moving back to my slide. So this we were talking. So we referred about this SWIM, UGC MHRD Digital Learning Initiative. All this learning initiative, whatever were shown in that you know, link, I have compiled it here in this slide, so you can have an idea. So everything is there. SWIM Prabha YouTube channel there. Vidyamitra is a YouTube channel. Please, Vidyamitra YouTube channel. You can see every subject which is covered in the UGC MOOCs is there in Vidyamitra YouTube channel. So in YouTube, videos are available for those content. This is by MHRD and Government of India. And please do remember that you can download them, but you cannot upload them into your own channel. Don't never ever do this thing because it is a copyright violation. Many people have done them, done this thing, but they have to face the consequences. So please, it is for free for teaching and learning. Utilize them in ethical manner. Okay. Now moving to the No preferred share and learn to share open educational resources. I think some of the speakers might have spoken on this particular topic. Open educational resources, OER Commons, OSS, Wikimedia Commons, OER University, OpenCourseWare, OpenStax College, Academic Earth, YouTube, SlideShare, Wikipedia. You know, you have to choose the contents, open educational resources for teaching and learning with due care, you know, because these are many. Many things are junks and crap. You have to, you know, collect a quality material and offer to your students or for your research members for teaching and learning. Okay. Now, moving to the developing the habit of online learning. This is a wonderful point that, you know, I was very uncomfortable when I saw your notice that be there at 9 a.m. So I was comfortable because generally nowadays my biological watch is completely changed, okay, due to this online learning. Anyway, I will continue my thing. Let's finish this particular point. That double check the thing, everything goes on record because you have to have that habit of online learning because everything goes on record. It is not your class with whatever you say, it is not going to be recorded. Everything is going to be recorded, everything goes on record. So you will have to double check your contents and each and every aspect of your lecture in effective way. So that's why this habit of online learning needs a good homework. You cannot go at random without preparation, as you might have most of you people who have more than 10 years or 15 years experience take their book or notes, maybe sometimes not without them, and enter into the class and just finish your class without any preparation. Oh, okay, you are wonderful. But no, it is not in the case of online learning. You will have to prepare for each and every class differently. Now, time management in online teaching learning. In e-learning, time management is utmost important. I liked, after, you know, addressing lot many webinars, I liked Mysore people, I would like to congratulate JSS Mysore, especially in limiting the time to 45 minutes. Wonderful. Yes, this is the need actually. It is futile to talk online for 2 hours and 3 hours. I don't know how people are doing this thing and how participants are able to concentrate on a particular topic of 3 hours or 4 hours. No, you can't do. Even in the physical classes, you can't do this thing. That's why our classes are 30 minutes, 40 minutes. And rather, I will let you know that a 30 minutes online learning is equivalent to 1 hour of complete teaching learning. So time management is utmost important. So time management, I was telling you before going to this thing, I will continue to my discussion that when I got the notice, okay, you will have to connect at 9 a.m. So I was afraid, because generally I used to wake up nowadays at 8:30 or 8:45 a.m. So, and that too, I came from my native place yesterday evening, late evening. So I was damn tired. So you will have to take care of time management, because it is always, convenient timing. See the third point, convenient timing. It may be unconventional. I am addressing many webinars which are in which timing is 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. It may be unconventional because our biological watch, our learning is completely at home. So at the timing may be unconventional. So please do remember. And so that's why you will have to understand the things. You cannot start at usual at your college college opening time or college closing time. Okay. So average engagement time for student and learning in one sitting, you will have to take care. No, you know your students. If you're teaching for quite many years, you might be knowing that average engagement time is not more than 10-15 minutes in physical classes, and online learning it is less than 6-7 minutes. Remember this, my words. This is the proven study that more than that's why in academic writing course, every 30 minute of module, e-module or video module have been divided into the three parts of 10 minutes. Okay, 6-7 minutes, some parts are there. So to just have an engagement that, okay, I get the thing on 6-7 minutes and done. You will see many courses of interest courses, LinkedIn learning courses. They are not more than 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes. Not courses. Courses are having the chunks of smaller videos. So data limit of student is also important. No person is having more than, hardly any person is having more than 1.5 GB or max 3 GB per day. So you cannot have, you cannot continue online learning for 3 hours or 4 hours or 5 hours for a day. So do not compare it with the physical class. Your presentation must be power packed. No, it is not a mythological story which you can continue for prolonged period of time and you can utter out n number of events. Power packed presentation is the utmost key. Please do remember this thing. Then organizing. What to organize? You will have to organize your time, content, students, coverage, and tune in with your daily life. That I was telling you that I have to tune my timings with my daily life, with my changed daily life in the post-COVID-19 scenario. And especially at any moment, you will have to take care of these things, time, contents, for which time you are going to talk, what will be your contents, point-wise, per slide, how much time you are going to give students, what are the students, diversity of your students, to whom you are talking with, what the coverage you should have. So you will have to organize these things. Okay. Now, learner-centric approach. Explore the engagement. I will detail this thing a little bit more, especially in terms of MOOCs, massive open online courses. Okay. Have faith on own teaching style and experience. Don't go with the expert comments and all that. You are the expert teacher yourself. So explore your engagement style, your own engagement style. There are no thumb rules. Focus on recall, revision, discussion, activity, assimilation quiz. And these things give the engagements even in the online classes. Okay. So engagement is at most important. I was seeing my nephew who was having the online class. So it's in school level one. So he was having his breakfast and all that, moving here and there and going to bathroom and all that during the online class. So this is not engagement. So you make this time comfortable so that if only the 30 minutes class is there, it should be attentive one. Everyone should be there with full attention. You should ensure it. And you cannot expect the engagement and the attentiveness if you are trying to deliver the things for hours and hours. So next thing is making it easy. You will, you know, agree with me. It is very important to make everything easy. Don't complicate the thing. It is very easy to complicate the thing. Don't use variety of LMS, the learning management system. You are in JSS College of Nursing. The teacher A or Professor A is taking the LMS for Moodle. Professor B is taking the LMS or Microsoft Teams. Professor C is taking the LMS from Google Classroom. Okay, so same class is being taught by three or four different LMS. Student will get confused. So try to adapt a single platform through which you should give the clear instructions that how to follow that particular thing. Then the student will follow and be attentive on. Okay, this is the key. So make it easy. Don't try to complicate the things. Next is maximizing the use of available resources. What is happening that you cannot have each and everything. You cannot have every software, app, tool. You cannot buy every time. You cannot buy every LMS every time. So whatever you are having, a laptop, tablet, PC, phone, you must utilize it fully. And you can do it even with the just having the mobile phone. You can do the e-learning, no issue. Just explore how you can do it. Learn using the common tools and teach the same to students. That how to learn from this thing. Okay? That students should be familiar of using this platform, whether you are using the Google Drive, how you should share the file through the Google Drive, Google Classroom, how can you can create the lectures, create the quiz, how you can, you know, create the questionnaires or whatever, Google Form, through the Google Forms, or how you can give the link of YouTube and give through the Classroom or Microsoft Teams. Do you know Microsoft Teams? It's a wonderful platform, like the Google Classroom. You know, like the Google Classroom, Microsoft Teams is a very good platform. Please do explore it. Google Group, WhatsApp, Telegram, you are doing it and you are using it, I know. But tactfully you can use Telegram. There is no limit of members in a particular group. So Telegram are very good for this thing. Facebook you can wonderfully use also for the teaching and learning. So each platform may have its unique properties. So do explore them. Whatever you are having, you can explore them. Then develop and share need-based e-content, OER and MOOCs, open educational resources and massive open online courses. What are the tools? They may be handwritten notes only. They may be, but you can scan the image. You can scan the flowchart and just share through the WhatsApp, Telegram or other platform using mobile. You can use the mobile for recording. You are having the selfie stick, just assemble the selfie stick and the camera and focus onto a piece of paper. You can have this talking head with webcam or laptop. You can, that in this discussion we are using the webcam, so with the laptop you can do the thing. PPT, VoiceOver, Loom, Canvas, recording free softwares like OBS. OBS is a free open source platform, recording software. You can do this. You can learn this freely available. Camtasia, freely available, or some are available. Some, at least some tiers are available for free. As far as the platform are concerned, do utilize YouTube. YouTube provides you unlimited, cloud space. You can say you can unlimited uploading of content can be done on the YouTube, SlideShare, OER Commons, LMS like Moodle. You can use podcasts, are the audio channels. Like they are wonderful for non-technical courses maybe, or for discussion point of view. If you want to give the message, you can do the podcast. Podcast is a very audio channels are there, like Anchor is there, SoundCloud, Castbox. They are freely available. Castbox is not free, but at least Anchor and SoundCloud is free podcast. podcast means you just have to record and you it will be uploaded automatically. So in 20 MB you will be able to deliver your address of 15-20 minutes in just 20 MB, because only voice is going there, over there. So only for the for the poor connectivity area, this is very good to connect with the podcast. Okay, and podcast is available in your mobile phone. So in your mobile you can take your class. So academic writing, this is one of our course. Third cycle of India's most popular MOOC is on. You can join us in our course through the Swayam MOOC, Swayam platform, swayam.gov.in, for free. And we have been number one in across India for our course in exam registration last cycle of July-October 2019. This cycle's course exam is still to be decided by the MHRD. So we are waiting for the decision. So the MHRD will decide. However, so we are entering into the third cycle. Right now I'm having more than 30,000 plus students across 85 countries for our courses. So I promise to trigger and excel an academic writer in you with this course of 15 weeks. We will be covering lot many things in 15 week course, which is going to be started on 27th of July. You are welcome to my course. Another course for, it is an industrial pharmacy. For pharmacy students, for biomedical students, it talks about the tablet, capsules, you know, pre-formulation and all that. However, it might not be that much relevant to the nursing one, but at least if you will enroll, you will learn the things that how you can, you know, develop the MOOCs, how you should do the things. I will give you some examples. This is my team of industrial pharmacy. It is going to be started on 27th of July. Sorry, academic writing is going to be started on 20th of July, and this industrial pharmacy is going to be started on the 27th of July. So both of the courses, which I am having this course first time in India. It is for student researchers. Right now for online teaching learning, I have went to a course platform of paid platform is there, PharmaState. For online teaching and learning, I have developed a course on PharmaState Academy. So if you apply the AJIND020, you can have the 200 rupees discount. During the COVID-19 scenario, I prepared this course for my own from my own resources. Around 5 hour courses there. So you are welcome if you want to learn. It's a course in a very simple, good mix of English as well as the Hindi, so that everyone can understand. These are my thoughts. Now moving to a little last portion, which I want to cover, that what are the keys of successful online course. First, you do, you must have a very good planning or outline, what you are going to cover, tools, content, presentation style, content writing, design presentation or presentation of multimedia, that what you are going to do, and uploading and sharing. Okay, and then feedback, assessment and certification can be planned. So content writer must be very good enough, good quality content must be there. You cannot, which is factually correct, and most importantly, it should be plagiarism free. You should not copy paste the things when you are preparing the online courses, okay? And your presentation must be engaging. So I am focusing on the engagement. Presentation of content, pardon friends, I am unable at this time to see the chat box. I'm just finishing it out, then I will see your comments and all that. I will take the questions. So just 2-3 slides more. Presentation of content. So learning outcome, they must be a tangible one. What you are going to do after doing this thing, you should cover things. So body must have cohesion and coherence. It means they should be connected with each other, not only with the grammatical point of view, but also with respect to the idea point of view. A slow and smooth progression of your content must be there. Okay. So Bloom taxonomy tells about the learning outcome. So you should also learn the things. You should use the words that you are going to build this thing. After doing this thing, you will be able to predict. You will be able to justify. You will be able to examine. You will be able to discriminate. These are things. You cannot say that you will be able to learn. You will be able to understand. These are the, you know, understand. You cannot. You don't have any scale of understanding. Na? So the whatever it tangible, the Bloom taxonomy say that you should use these words. So then the presentation of content. Infographics, good. Effective use of MS Office, Excel, and Origin, whatever you like. powerful summary must be there. 4-5 punch points at last of the at the last you must have references, further links, and live links. The links must be working one, and they should be giving. You should not give a particular article which is not available online for free. You try to give the things which are directly available. As far as the video is concerned, keep it simple, natural, and power packed. Time 10 to 20 minutes, depending on the subjects. Be comfortable. Positive body language you must have. Practice, rehearse, and then record. Please, I agree that you are a very good teacher. I agree that you are a very good orator. I agree that you are a very good communicator. But in any case, you should rehearse whatever you are going to deliver in a particular 10 minutes video, even without any flaw. You should be able to deliver the things. Production editing from big projects are needed. However, smaller projects you can do yourself. But for big MOOCs, editing require big teams. So recording editing, for that you should have a basic knowledge of MS Office, open source, OBS free tier of that CamStudio, Camtasia, etc. Presentation, of course, rational should be there. It should be justified that what you are going to, why you are preparing this course, what is the reach, who is the target learner, what is the unique selling point, USP of that particular course, how the topics have been bundled in each other, that platform, in which platform you are going to deliver. You can deliver into Udemy, you can deliver into any course, an academy, they are freely available. If you will take without preparation a particular course into a platform, we always see very positive things in ourselves when we are standing before a mirror, but actually you need the perfection. So you must be, it should be easy to follow, affordable for certification for learning. So whenever the paid program is there, it should be affordable one. That's why we are unable to do the Coursera and edX courses, because they are associated with $300 fees for certification. That's why. So you will have to select a particular price range also if you are going for a paid course. So student engagement tools, instructor himself or herself is an engagement tool. Classic teaching style for engagement, active, natural body language, smile, voice, modulation, pause. These are required, Activity, ungraded, graded, keep it simple. Assessment, self-assessment, graded quiz, mix of recall level and assimilation questions. Recall level, just whatever you have told, you are just telling them to recall. Assimilation means what, so that they should, you have not taught that particular thing specifically, but you are asking a advanced level question so that they can think. It's called assimilation level question. So different types of strategies must be practiced. Student engagement tool, this is very important, live demo. If you are teaching nursing, can you prepare a small video how to cannulate, how to deliver a SC injection or IM injection, how to go for the dosage regimen, how to go for a IP injection, live demo. Can you do that and then prepare it and then give this thing into your course? So live interaction, support system, discussion forum, these are the keys of a successful MOOC program. And this needs passion. Technology cannot do wonders. You will have to be very attentive in answering the queries. I think if any learner is here from my previous run courses, they might be aware of the thing that we are very cautious about getting back to our learners. So I thanks a lot to JSS Mysore, first of all, then our mentors, UGC, CEC, EMRC, IIM Bangalore, in which I have been trained. I was the lucky enough to be selected among the top 25 people who were selected for IIM Bangalore training, NITR Chennai. And I always quote, who dares to teach must never cease to learn. John Cotton Dana. It's one of my favorite quotes. I'll be stopping my sharing. Meanwhile, you can go with this thing. I'm having a YouTube channel, Open Knowledge, in my name. Open Knowledge is the channel link. So I'm HNBGU. Academic Writing Facebook group is there. Industrial Pharmacy Facebook group is there. This is my email ID and this is my phone number. You're welcome to contact at any point of time. From Gadwal University, which is a central university in Uttarakhand, it's on the way to Badrinath. from Rishikesh to Badrinath, when you go, it's in the midway, in the uphill of Shivalik, in Himalayas. So, welcome to you. The session is on for your question Q&A. Over to you, moderators.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there are a few questions, sir. Will you please answer this question, sir? Okay. The first question is, sir, have you come across with any MOOC which is specifically developed for nursing students, like disaster nursing, infection control program, or forensic nursing, etc., by an Indian or foreign universities? If so, please mention, sir.
Yes, I will let you know. Just a minute. First of all, you will have to explore the things, first of all. That, however, I don't remember exactly, but I can see the things. I'm sharing the screen. I just scroll it down, how you can search it, how you can search the things. Let me tell you. Screen. I will share my screen again. And let me search the thing for you people. Okay. Yeah. Say, for example, yes, I went to the Swayam website and typed simply nursing. Okay. Let me check if there's. Ask keywords are not there, but you can check that biomedical one. In the biomedical one, what you have to do, you click the all courses and just scroll down. Okay, if you are having the courses, some particular, I think the smaller courses of two, one like learning and teaching, pedagogy, basic engagement time, these are the courses, advanced C++. Craft. I'll get back to you. If I go, what you can do, you have to scroll down the things through these platform of Swayam. I think in nursing, I would like to let you know that I was the first person to prepare a MOOC from pharmacy. I'm the only one in India who has developed a course in pharmacy. Actually, pharmacy and nursing, you will agree with me, are the most neglected one in educational scenario. If you compare with the medicine, engineering and other things, we are the unfortunate one to get the limelight. What I request you, all you people, that please do explore the things. Say, for example, I think the course must be there in Coursera. Udemy is there, it's a paid course. No, it's nursing MOOCs and free online courses. MOOC list, if you see. I couldn't get any thing. What I request in edX, learn nursing with online nursing classes. In edX, there is a course, okay. So it is very a good opportunity for you people that you can develop the online courses through the MOOCs and apply to the Swayam for developing the courses. So first, what you need to do, like nursing courses are available there, mechanical ventilation for COVID-19, hypertension in primary care, CSI, ME cases, dementia. These are some of the courses from edX. I think in edX also, the courses are free for learn maybe, and for certification only they require the price, that cost is there. So what I request you, that it is a golden opportunity for you people also, for pharmacy as well as the nursing one. So you can come up with some courses which are core one or 4-credit course or 3-credit course, and you can develop a course and you can plan a course and put the proposal to the MHRD through the CEC or through the other thing. Government platforms are available there. If you go to the CEC.org, I mean, Consortium for Educational Communication. There is a pro forma of applying the thing. However, it takes time, 8 to 9 months it takes. In my case, it took around 8 to 9 months for getting it reviewed, peer reviewed. And then if it is accepted, the grant is given to you. Okay, you get the chance to record the things. You need not to be expert on recording. The expert team in Educational Multimedia Resource Center of Government of India are there, which record these things. And for you people, and you will have to prepare with your contents and the, and you will have to present that. So it is a golden opportunity, even if the things are not there. Meanwhile, what you can do, you can compile all your lectures and prepare, have a good team. Not a single person can do, you know, doing it is as a single person. I did it for single person. You know, it took my 2 years like this for developing if two courses. All together, academic writing and Ministry of Pharmacy. So having a good team will give you a good chance. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I think once we will take up a course in Swayam, I think from our college, few of us have completed the academic writing course under your guidance in Swayam, sir. I think after that we were more interested and you. Were more interested to develop the OER specifically. Okay, and now it is COVID-19 lockdown has made us to make use of what we have learned and we have implemented most of the things. But I think definitely we will take up the challenge and as your suggestion, definitely I think we can move forward. In, we were thinking whether we need any registration to develop these MOOCs. Anything, sir? Only from the MHRD permission we need or any other permissions or registration is necessary, sir?
For which?
For developing this MOOCs.
In registering, but?
Any agency or anything we have to
register? Just a minute, I'm switching off my phone. Just a minute, hold on. Yeah. Fan, I have to switch off. Yeah, please.
If we are now interested to develop the e-learning materials, do we need to have any registration with any agencies, anything?
No. What you need to do, if your institute is 2F12B, okay, you are able to get the grant. The grant is given actually to the EMRC. I think in Mysore, EMRC is there or not, I don't remember. But I think it must be there. Educational Multimedia Resource Center, it is called. It is UGC's consortium. You will have to apply to the CEC, Consortium for Educational Communication, in a particular format. You must be a teacher with 10 years experience, okay, 5 to 10 years experience. And you need to apply in a proper format with an introductory video, okay? Two, three minutes introductory video is there. For a trial video, you can see my introductory videos. You go to the YouTube, academic writing trial video or whatever. So I had made it public for you people so that you can learn the things that how to create the introductory video. You can prepare, say for example, this I'm recording my introductory video. Okay, you see. So hello friends, welcome to my course. Thanks for choosing my course. So let's learn academic writing in my course. We will learn that how to create thesis, how to write the thesis, how to prepare the papers, how to avoid the plagiarism. We will give you the contents and audio video and the further links in our 15-week course. So join us in our course in this web. So it should be in 2-3 minutes. Okay, like this you will have to prepare and with some slides of whatever you are, if objective slides is there. So you will have to record this 2-3 minute video so that they can judge, the experts can judge your body language, your presentation, that how much comfortable, camera friendly you are. Okay, so this is a key that, this 2-3 minutes video is very important, very crucial, that you should be very, very comfortable. Even you record it from your mobile only, it will work, no issue. That what is important that the content, your delivery and your presentation is very important. Okay, on the basis of that, you can develop the courses. You can propose the courses for developing and then you can get the grant. However, you don't get the grant, you are paid for the developing the each module of 30 minutes. And this 30 minute video is equivalent to 1 hour of teaching learning material. And you will have to record 20 hours of video for a 4-credit course. It depends on if you are going for a 2-credit course, then only 10 hours video will work. No issue. Okay. So see your syllabi. And if what is the advantage that you can earn the credits across, your student can earn the credits through that. So actually, if you are taking the pain for developing the MOOCs now, you are becoming virtually immortal, because you and your contents are going to be there in the virtual world always. So what I feel that if you're a good teacher, please go ahead with proposal submission. It may take little bit of time, but the preparation must be good. Come with a good team who will prepare the content, who will deliver. It is not necessary that you are writing and you are presenting. It may be like that someone other is writing the content, and if some other person is good in delivering, he or she can deliver it. Okay, or you can both. You can do both the things. Okay. So, and you should also be very good in PowerPoint presentation and slides, because they are the things which gives you the winning edge in that particular course. Okay, so it is very high time for nursing people come up with the courses. I would love to see any nursing courses from JSS Mysore in future. Thank you.
Definitely, sir. We'll contact you if you need help.
Sure, I'm always there with you.
So one more last question, sir. If the students wish to join, whether he can join himself or he should join through the college or any organization?
No. If you want to join the course through the, anyone can join. Your sabjiwala can join, your motor mechanic can join, your student can join, as a housewife you can join. If a housewife wants to learn how to develop a rocket, she can learn. Nobody can check you. Okay. This is the anyone, anytime, anywhere. Okay. You want to learn. It is not just about, nursing, pharmacy. It is about complete learning. If I want to, I'm already very much interested. I come from the families of Brahmins. Okay. But I don't know anything about the Karma Kanda and all that. I want to learn that thing. So I can enroll any course on Karma Kanda. I can enroll any course on astrology. Okay, I love interior decoration. I can learn the thing and forget about all the things. You see your your kids starting from 9 to 12th and all things, they can learn the courses through the MOOCs. 11, 12th, biology, chemistry. These are the courses really available. You don't need any tutor, Baba. So go to the Swayam MOOCs and get your student, get your kids. Give the benefit to your kids. Apne padosi, you tell your neighbors, you tell your relatives. Okay, the things are available in the Swayam MOOCs, which are prepared by the experts of NCERT. Okay, so just also for the 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, I'm telling you. So it is not just about the higher education. It is about for every kind of education, whether it is conventional, unconventional, or vocational. And anyone can learn anything. If I want to learn Sanskrit, nobody can check me. Okay. So do learn. Okay.
Thank you.
There is no prerequisite.
Thank you, sir, for your very interactive and informative session and making us to understand the process of developing the e-learning. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. धन्यवाद आप सबका, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. थैंक यू, थैंक्स अ लॉट. एंड प्लीज फील फ्री टू कॉन्टैक्ट एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इफ यू नीड एनी हेल्प. एंड आई वुड लव टू सी द नेक्स्ट फर्स्ट नर्सिंग कोर्स फ्रॉम जेएसएस कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी. बेस्ट ऑफ लक.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू सो मच सर. नाउ लेट अस वाइंड अप विद मॉर्निंग सेशन. आफ्टरनून वी हैव पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशंस. दोस्त हु आर प्रेजेंटिंग द पोस्टर्स